In this problem, we have one person dropping a rock off a balcony and another person simultaneously throwing a rock upward toward the balcony. And we're interested in finding out when the rocks pass each other and at what height do they pass each other. And the key to a one-dimensional kinematics problem like this with two objects is to write down the position as a function of time for each object using the same coordinate system for each object. And then we can just set the two positions equal and find out what time it is. So just to be clear about the origin here, we're going to put the origin at ground level. And we're going to call upward positive. And then I need to get a position function for each of these rocks. So the position for rock A, so this is the person dropping it from the balcony, is given by the one-dimensional kinematics formula y0 plus v0 yt plus a 1/2 ayt squared. And then plugging in what we know about this rock, the initial position is 5 meters. The initial speed is 0. So that term vanishes. And then this rock is in free fall. So the acceleration is going to be negative g, or negative 9.8. And then I have my t squared. So to clean things up a little bit, the position of rock A as a function of time, I'll just emphasize this is a function of time. It's going to be 5 minus 4.9 t squared. And then anytime you plug a t into that, you find out the location of this rock. And we do the same thing now for rock B. And rock B is released from a height of 1.6 meters above the ground with an initial velocity of 12 meters per second. So we'll put that in. There's a 12t term. And then the acceleration term looks the same. We plug in an acceleration of negative 9.8 because this thing is also in vertical freefall. And just to clean that up and write it as a function of time, I get 1.6 plus 12t minus 4.9t squared. Now that we have those carefully set up, so the position of each rock is described as a function of time using exactly the same coordinate system for each rock. All I have to do is say, if the two positions of these rocks are equal to each other, what time is it? So we plug in those functions of time and I have a 5 minus 4.9 t squared for rock A. And then for rock B, a 1.6 plus 12 t minus 4.9 t squared. And now we can just solve for t, and we'll have the time corresponding to the two positions being the same. In other words, that's the moment where they pass each other. Now the quadratic terms cancel out because the acceleration of each rock is the same because they're both in vertical free fall. Now I'm going to subtract 1.6 from both sides, giving me a 3.4 on the left and a 12t on the right. And finally, I get the time at which these rocks pass each other. And this comes out to 0.283 seconds. In part B, I'm asked to find the height at which the rocks pass each other. So all we have to do is take that time of 0.283 seconds, and we could plug into either one of the position functions, and they both should give us the same answer for the height. I prefer to actually plug into both equations because it provides a really nice check on our work. So let's look at the height of rock A, evaluated at 0.283 seconds. So you just replace T with 0.283. And when I run the numbers on this, I get a height of 4.61 meters. Which again, for our coordinate system, means 4.61 meters above the ground. Notice that that's a height below the balcony, which makes sense because this thing is immediately falling downward when it's released. Evaluating the height of rock B at a time of 0.283 seconds. Into three sig figs on this one, I get 4.60 meters. So we get a slight discrepancy caused by rounding error propagating through the calculation. But that's pretty strong confirmation that we've done everything correctly here. We get the same position for each rock at that special time of 0.283 seconds. If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.